You want to see the front?
I want to see the front.
Sorry.
Suspending our musical performance because we have a special public service announcement that I've asked Ms. Snyder to make. So please welcome Ms. Snyder.
Right. Last night, John Bapst was the target of yarn bombing. These random acts of knitting can be found on the stairwells, doorknobs, posts, and trophy case. Even Sakara Auditorium was not safe from these guerrilla knitters. Surveillance cameras caught the following students in the act. Rest assured that as the obvious members of the Simple Gifts Club, we were the first to be questioned, but we can neither confirm nor deny any involvement in such wanton acts of randy graffiti. There have been yarn bombing skirmishes coming around all over the place, including Little Scout Hegan, Maine, Paris, and London, to name a few. It seems to be a movement that is fast becoming worldwide. Nothing seems to be safe from these extreme knitters. They've even managed to cover an entire bus. And girls, who wouldn't want to be picked up in prom with one of these beauties? Perhaps the elite forces of the world join Simple Gifts and train with the best. Thank you.
So something a little different this morning. Awareness of the environment. So to lead this assembly, I'm asking Christina Long, who's the Vice President of SEEK, to come on up and take us for the rest. Christina.
So first of all, we'll start off with the coin drive statistics. We've made about $83. We want to give up more. So the people, we've got people that are passing around the buckets. So if you could put coins and dollar bills in there, that would be great. But remember that dollar bills count against and coins count for. So keeping that in mind, I'll tell you who's leading and who's not. Seniors, you have -$4.09. Juniors, you have -$2.25. Sophomores, you have $8. And freshmen, you have $26. So, I'll be announcing the who won the coin drive at the end of the day, so please be listening for that, because the winner gets a free jeans and t-shirt tomorrow. If you don't win, you can still wear jeans and a t-shirt, but you have to pay $1. So, a little bit of history about Earth Day. It was founded in the 1970s, and the reason it was April 22nd was because it was on a Wednesday, and Wednesday was a good day for getting people to be involved with environmental rallies, and about 20 million people participated in the first Earth Day. So.